Hey, thanks for joining us. This is my friend Jerry, and he comes in with some skin lesions we're gonna evaluate. We're gonna be able to get a biopsy of this thing that's been growing on your nose that sometimes you can scratch off.
For quite some time now.
Yeah. Yeah? But this one on your ear, how long has it been growing?
At least a year.
Okay, when we
since
do
I
need...
was last had it looked at and had it frozen, it's been about a year.
Had it frozen, seemed to respond to getting frozen, but...
Yeah, for a short time.
Something grew back.
Yeah.
So, in my estimation, and I showed the picture to Dr. Gwain, we agree it looks like a type of cancer called squamous cell carcinoma.
Right.
Skin cancer, not the bad type of skin cancer like malignant melanoma that spreads everywhere. It doesn't look like that. But should be operated further. We'll refer you to Dr. Trauner, who's done work on some of our patients and is actually on a video doing a procedure not too unlike he would probably do for this. So we'll communicate with them and find out about getting you set up with them. As far as lesion on the nose, we don't know for sure. We're gonna shave it off and send it off and get some pathology back. Do you mind if I put in the description of the video the results?
Oh, absolutely not.
Okay.
No, if it helps people, this is good.
Okay, and we'll tell you first, of course.
Okay.
All right. You ready? Mm-hmm. Okay, just hold still, because this is bad. I'll just say out up front, it's bad. I don't know how you're holding that still. I think at this point, it might start to be getting a little less painful, a little more tolerable.
It's not bad.
Not that bad?
Mm-mm.
Well, we are using some buffer in the medicine, so it's not as stingy. Tiny, tiny needle. I inject slowly because it hurts less if you inject slowly. Some people have this idea that the priority is get the anesthetic in as quick as they can, so it'll start numbing.
Mm-hmm. You've probably done this before.
That hurts when they do that. I had that done to me once. So you've got a big white area on the tip of your nose from the medicine that's in it called epinephrine, which we used to.
I do that. You say I have a big white spot on my nose.
Yeah, because it pushes the blood out and closes the blood vessels a little bit. Let me switch hands on this. Now this is the worst part of this. That's right. The worst part of this is you can completely see what I'm doing.
It's a little blurry.
A little blurry that close?
Mm-hmm.
Slips. I gotta hold the nose steady with the forceps. I will have to have you close your eyes for this part because I don't want this, mm-hmm. it dries whatever it touches. Okay, let's see how it's coming here. You can actually open your eyes and we're gonna have you, in order to get some of that powder off, actually close your eye while I have you turn onto your right side.
Sure.
So this is just gonna kind of flake off onto the paper or not. You already got the extras. Go ahead and sit up sideways or sideways. Move sideways so you can sit up. Let me flake some of that. Get that little spot of blood off. And take that off. So the idea of this is so that you don't have to have a Band-Aid that you're just going to keep bleeding into.
Right.
And it'll flake off as a scab would. We have some discharge instructions for taking care of it after you get out. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. I wanted to let you know that Jerry will be back in the next video for getting that lesion completely removed. I spoke with the surgeon, I spoke with Jerry, and the agreement was that we would actually do a shave biopsy in our office. We'll explain it in the future video, so be sure to watch that. I do need to thank Lindsay Antwine, BooBoo Kitty, and Petra Rosenberg. Thank you so much for those patrons. And if you want to be on Patreon, please do click on the link to be able to participate on these videos and also to get some of the behind-the-scenes footage. Until next time, Dr. Mark Vaughan telling you to stay in good health.